live on Facebook. This is going to be our weekly training guide. And we have a little bit of housekeeping, first of all, with the gentleman in the audience, marketing. We have to become very intentional about it. We were just talking about marketing. And there is a group out in San Diego that meets once a month. And for us, we'll meet once a month at the end of the month and say, okay, what are we doing? What are we not doing? Right now, we're not doing a lot when it comes to marketing, so it's just starting. But we have to meet and think about what's working, what's not working, what are trendy items to bring up, and what are trendy things not to bring up. So that's the marketing aspect. I have 5 bullet points. Very heavy bullet points, by the way. So this is something I heard a couple of years ago and actually makes sense now because everyone's kind of down right now. You kind of feel this collective consciousness that's a little getting dragged through either the media, negativity, things that are going on, interest rates, the economy. There's a lot of negativity, and obviously it's getting pushed, and it's an intentional push to make people just, you know, kind of feel bad about life and that it's meaningless and everything else. But what the podcast said many years ago, and it resonates so much right now, is that we have to maximize our life for energy. And energy, that is natural methods, which is exercise. We have to prioritize healthy food. We have to prioritize water and laughter and sleep and prayer and things that are basic and free. These are free things. Obviously, exercise, you could walk or run. Sleep, that's free. Water is free. Laughter is free. Having a good time is free. You know, that's one of the things that I need to work on is being less serious and essentially just embracing the serious aspect of business, but also being able to have fun. But maximizing our day and our life around energy. Does this give me energy? When I'm on social media, does this give me energy? No. When I'm done with TikTok, am I happy that I just scrolled through TikTok? No, I'm not. So maximizing, it could be people, it could be events, it could be shows, it could be dinners, or it could be anything. When you leave, how do you feel afterwards? Do you feel drained? A lot of the recent days I've felt drained because I'm not doing the highest and best use of my time. I'm doing things that I have to do, which ironically leads to the next point, which is you have a right to the action, not the fruit of the action. This goes biblical 101, which is you have the right to the action. In other words, taking action towards exercise, making phone calls, having a better relationship, saving money, investing money, whatever the case is, but you don't have the fruit, you're not deserved the fruit of the said action. In other words, the outcome of that action. So if you believe you deserve, this is what I wrote down, if you believe you deserve the future just because you took action, the future could be a better body, a better mindset, healthier relationship, more happiness, whatever the case is, just because you took action doesn't mean that you deserve it, and that is the disease of entitlement. That's the disease of anything. Just because people even exist, they feel they're entitled to certain things without even the action. Then there's some people that take one action a week. You know, the biggest thing that I got away from my coach, my triathlon coach, when I first started working with her in 2019, she said there's three ways to action. The first is longevity. So if I go to the gym, longevity is 3 hours or 1 hour. So it's longevity. Intensity is the second thing, is while I'm there at the gym for, say, an hour, do I go really hard or do I sit back and I'm scrolling through my cell phone and I do like 3 or 4 reps? And then the third, which is the most important about building habit and action, is consistency. She said, I'd rather you go less duration and less intense, but be consistent. And, you know, for Eric and I, that's about making calls and being consistent about the calls, and that the fruit is gonna happen. We don't deserve the fruit yet because we're only about 2 to 3 weeks in or a month in, and we're dialing in the actions. So until it's about 6 months down the line, we can't say where's our fruit because that's entitlement. And also we haven't been as consistent over a period of time where we could stack all these wins. Moving on. Growth is a choice we make, and it doesn't just happen by chance. Growth is a continuous, conscious process we make every single day. Every single day. This is the same thing that Jim Rome always talked about. He said, you take a shower once doesn't mean you're going to be clean tomorrow. motivation is just like taking a shower. It is removed every day. Like, you have to not feel motivated. You have to be like, listen, if I don't do something, what is the outcome? Motivation is temporary. It's fleeting. People use it as the feeling. I feel like going to the gym. I feel like making calls. I feel like eating healthy. I feel like having fun, laughing, things like that. But it's a conscious effort that we have to make every single day, and it doesn't happen by chance. The last thing is that people, part of this new age, personal growth, self-development, Tony Robbins kind of crowd, which it's nothing against Tony. He changed my life and saved my life in 2009. But a lot of people, they're striving for happiness, and you see it everywhere. Just be happy. Whatever you do, just be happy. Go into a relationship, be happy. Eat whatever you want, be happy. But happiness actually, and I've read a lot of books on this. There's a author called Ben Tal Shahar, and he wrote a book, 10%, well, 10% happy, 10% happier is a different book. Happiness is a choice. Happiness paradox. There's a bunch of things that say that people want to be happy, but being happy is actually the result of doing something. And as I wrote down, it happens on the way to fulfillment. It's not the prerequisite to fulfillment. So people want to be fulfilled by being in a relationship, and then over time it deteriorates, or they get business and then their happiness of getting said business deteriorates. And the reason being is that A, the motivation to make phone calls that got you the business waned, and now you're not making the phone calls, or the happiness that you got waned because on the way to fulfillment, there's not another thing that has filled it, which is another piece of business or making more phone calls or reaching out for referrals or saving money or whatever the case it is for you. You go to the gym on Monday, doesn't mean you're going to feel amazing on Wednesday. So it's the exact same thing here with happiness. Everyone talks about happiness, but they don't talk about actually how to get happiness. Happiness is on the way to fulfillment. And I don't even like the word happiness. I like the word content. Content is the best word because the guy that runs the impact theory, I don't know how to say his last name, but Tom Bilyeu, I don't know how to say his last name. He came out with an energy bar. I'm also forgetting that name. And he became, worth hundreds of millions of dollars, I think, maybe. But he said something very interesting when it comes to happiness. He said that on the way to happiness, A, it's a choice, but B, it comes from deliberately doing what you need to do. So we could say, hey, listen, I don't feel happy, but you're not making your bed, you're not cleaning your room, you're not doing the basics, so why would you think that actually going to the gym is going to make you happy? And also, going to the gym once isn't going to make you happy. Going to the gym multiple times to the way to fulfillment is actually going to make you happy. So I look at it as content. This is the quote he says, contentness is being happy by yourself when no one's around and you're doing absolutely nothing. When you're just sitting by yourself on your couch or at work, there's no distractions, there's nothing around. How do you feel by yourself when you're with yourself and nothing is, that is true contentness, not happiness, it's true content, because you're content with yourself. You're content with your decisions. And I'll leave it on this, is that if you don't feel content in those moments, you have to use that. Creation gave you that as a guide to do different action. You have to do different action if you don't feel content. So that's it for today. We're going to be coming every single Tuesday. Little tidbits that we think of on the way to becoming a better company, better version of ourselves, better real estate. If you guys have any articles, we come live we upload our real estate news articles on Thursday. We film them on Thursday. If there's ones you want us to react to, then send it over to us. Have a great day, and we will.